It is an overcast day here in Dover, Delaware, but the speeds are up. The on-track activity is going to be hot as well. The MBNA Gold 400, they run for the Bud Pole this afternoon here on Speed Vision. Hi, everybody. I'm Eli Gold. Welcome to the Monster Mile, Dover Downs International Speedway. It's already been a busy day as we get set to run for the Bud Pole for the NASCAR Winston Cup stop here on Sunday. Who's been quick? Well, the normal list of suspects, certainly. Mark Martin was fast today. Ernie Irvin has been quick. Jeff Gordon. Dick Trickle has been running well in the Heilig Myers Ford. Of course, we may see a repeat winner of the Bud Pole, but there have been 12 different winners who've started on the inside of the front row this season. We'll all find out together over the course of the next couple of hours who'll be leading them to green come Sunday. Let's bring you up to speed on the storylines of the day. First off, why are the speeds up? Because the racetrack has changed just a little bit. You see the light spots there in the foreground of the screen? That, along with other areas around the 1 mile, are the spots that were smoothed out when the Indy Racing League ran here back in July. There you see another location on the racetrack where a laser grader was used to take out some of the old bumps. The track is smoother, more predictable, and as a result, you're able to run with a little more abandon. We're seeing that today from all of the NASCAR Winston Cup drivers. Secondly, Steve Grissom's team is in the news. The Kodiak Ice Car, awaiting their chance to qualify, is out of provisional starting spots. If they're going to be in the field on Sunday, they've got to get in on speed either today or tomorrow. They have no more provisional starting spots available to them. The other story today that has really had everybody down in the mouth has been the fact that Bill Elliott is not here this weekend. Bill's dad, George, passed away last night at the age of 74. He had had surgery for a cancerous brain tumor, but unfortunately lost his battle with cancer last night. Matt Kenseth, the young standout from the NASCAR Busch Series, is driving the McDonald's car today, certainly tomorrow in practice. Should Bill Elliott be here on Sunday, he would drive in the MBNA Gold 400. Otherwise, it will be Kenseth's ride for the weekend. So those are some of the major storylines of the day. But Glenn Jarrett, I guess the other one is something that I mentioned very quickly as we signed on. It's an overcast day today. That's helping a lot of fellas find their way around the Monster Mile.
Oh, absolutely, Eli, no question about it. I'm going to be covering the front end of pit road today. I'll talk to the guys before they go out, try to find out what they think you might be able to do in the qualifying run. But you are exactly right. Speeds are up. The overcast conditions, temperatures in only the mid-70s, and plus the smooth racing surface have raised the speeds up in practice. Mark Martin unofficially broke the track record in practice. There has already been a Busch Series qualifying record, so I think the Winston Cup track record may fall. Right now, Rusty Wallace holds that at 23.092 seconds. I think that may fall before the end of this afternoon. Joining me on pit road today, here's Steve Burns.
Hey, thanks a lot, Glenn. I'll talk to the drivers after they make their qualifying run. Now, there's some interesting numbers here in play. There have been 57 Winston Cup events here at Dover. Of those races, only 7 races have been won from the pole. But the interesting number, of those 57 races, 47 of them have been won from inside the top 10. So the first 5 rows are where you want to start the race here at Dover. Eli?
And qualifying today, Steve, here on Speed Vision will really be up for grabs because all the way back in the next to last qualifying spot today, Bobby Labonte, he has a shot at the Bud Pole. We are live on Speed Vision. Bud Pole qualifying being brought to you by Mobil 1 Synthetic Motor Oil. Nothing outperforms Mobil 1. By Miller Lite, who reminds you to enjoy Miller Lite with friends. And by Pep Boys, cars like us, people love us. Welcome back, everybody. The sun now trying to pop through the overcast here at Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. We've got a crowd today for qualifying that was equal to some Winston Cup race day crowds, not all that many years ago. Right now on the racetrack, the continuation of qualifying for the NASCAR Busch Series, the Timberwolf Chevrolet of Mark Green. Everybody is chasing Bobby Labonte right now in the NASCAR Busch Series. They run the MBNA Gold 200 here tomorrow. Bobby Labonte's speed of 153.055, the quickest lap of the day. He's in the shell car that normally is campaigned by Tony Stewart, but Stewart elsewhere this weekend with Indy Racing League obligations, and as a result, Bobby Labonte drives that machine. Mark Green currently in 18th place overall in qualifying. And the second lap that he takes here will keep him in the qualifying session in 18th overall. So Bobby Labonte still fastest with Joe Bessie, who won here a year ago, sharing the front row with him. If you've never been to Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware, take a look at the Shell track map. It looks as though it's a fairly normal 1 mile oval, but it is a little tricky. The turns are 10 feet wider than the straightaways. The turns are banked 24 degrees, and the straightaways themselves are banked 16 degrees. So there's really no chance for a breather at all around this track that is appropriately called the Monster Mile. That is Elton Sawyer. He's on the speedway now in the Barbersol Ford, car number 38. Elton Sawyer's had some good runs here in the past. That 23-second lap just completed there will put him in 13th place overall. As Glenn told you before, the track record numbers have already crashed down for the NASCAR Busch Series here, with Bobby Labonte showing the way. The second lap for Elton Sawyer will keep him in 13th spot overall at the 151.534. Later on in our telecast, Johnny Benson is going to be making his way up here to the tower to sit alongside me and bring you coverage of Bud Pohl qualifying on Speed Vision. But Glenn Jarrity can't join me quite yet.
No, that's because I've held him down here on pit road. I've got him captive right now. Johnny, we appreciate your willingness to join us as soon as you do your qualifying there. You were 23rd fastest in the last practice session. The whole key today is to try to get into that top 25. Can you do it?
Well, we sure hope so. You know, we're 23rd and ran a 36, and the guy who ran a 31 is sitting there about 16th. It's just real tight. So we just hope we get the good lap we want. Going first is not going to help, but I guess it's going to help me getting up the booth, because they come and ask me after you go, you got to come up there? I don't care.
Well, we appreciate you joining us. As I said, good luck to you on your qualifying run. We'll let you get your car. Thanks.
Johnny Benson, he has drawn the first number today for NASCAR Winston Cup Bud Pohl qualifying. The last of the qualifiers today will be the gum-out Pontiac for Derek Cope. Back in a moment. Everybody just waiting their turn. The final moments of qualifying for the NASCAR Busch Series underway. Then the NASCAR Winston Cup teams take to the Monster Mile. Bud Pohl qualifying upcoming at around 3:30 Eastern time for the NASCAR Winston Cup cars. There's Bobby Hillen's car, and as we roll the tape, you'll see what transpired about 40 minutes or so ago. He was quick today, 7th fast in practice, but not in qualifying. Around he went in the clean shower machine, ending his chances today. Bobby Hillen, right now last among the drivers, 39th overall. Though this has been a good week for Bobby and his wife Kim. They became parents for the third time on Sunday when Bobby Jr. was born. Let's go back down to pit road.
Well, Eli, you know, by my count, there are 10 guys that are doing double duty here this weekend. By that, I mean they're going to run in the Busch race Saturday and in the Winston Cup race on Sunday. One of those is this guy right here, Kevin LePage. Kevin qualified his Busch car. I believe you're 12th right now. What we want to know, how about the Winston Cup car? You guys have been running great.
Yeah, Glenn, the last few weeks, the Prime Star Taurus has been running real good. And just have the little gremlins that, you know, bit us last week at Richmond and the week before at Darlington. But I'll tell you, the communication that James Ince and I have developed here in a short period of time, it's no wonder why we're running good. I mean, when we get in the car, we talk about it, we understand it, And, you know, the performance is showing. But this is what Jack wanted us to do, is run these 13 races this year, figure out the Ford Taurus, find these gremlins that's been biting that team for the past few years, and get them fixed. So when next year when we roll around, we'll be ready to go racing. And I'll tell you, the guys are just doing a great job for us. And, you know, I can't wait for, you know, here tomorrow and next week and the week after and next year, really.
Can you tell he's excited? I tell you what, guys, he seems to, this man seems to have that knack to communicate with anybody anywhere he goes. He's run well in every car he's been in this year.
From Shelburne, Vermont, Kevin LePage without the mustache, which was removed just a few weeks ago. There you see the names that are atop the leaderboard right now for the NASCAR Busch Series as their qualifying winds to a close. You're looking at the FINA Chevrolet driven by Randy LaJoy. He has just qualified for tomorrow's MBNA Gold 200 in 30th starting spot. 149.913 miles an hour for Randy LaJoy. And now the final qualifier pulling out onto the speedway will be Ed Berrier. He was the winner at Hickory earlier this year. Meanwhile, while Berrier has some experience here at Dover Downs, Jerry Nadeau of Danbury, Connecticut, has no previous NASCAR experience here at the Monster Mile. Steve Burns, it's got to be an imposing place to come and race for the first time.
Yep, and let's find out how he feels. Jerry, Eli just said you don't have experience on this track, but how do you feel going into qualifying?
I feel pretty good. You know, we had a pretty good practice run the first session. So far, things are going well. You know, these guys been here a bunch of times with Lake Speed, and they ran real good when they were here. So I'm really looking forward to Sunday. All I hear is it's going to be a tough race. It's a long race, and it's probably one of the hardest races of the year. So I feel like I'm fit. I'm ready to go. Last time I was here, I had a little stomach virus, so I didn't get any laps on the racetrack. But I'm excited. Cartoon Network, everybody's doing a great job.
All right, best of luck.
Thanks a lot.
Jerry Nadeau set to go racing here at the Monster Mile. There's Ed Berrier taking a 31st qualifying spot here today. So he should be all set for tomorrow's running of the MBNA Gold 200 as the NASCAR Busch Series teams have now set the pole with Kevin Grubb, quickest of the lot, sharing the front row with Bobby Labonte, Joe Bessie, who won here a year ago, and Matt Kenseth sharing the front row, and veteran Dick Trickle of Wisconsin Rapids, Wisconsin, who has won two poles here at the Monster Mile. He will be starting fifth. A good run today for Andy Santerre, following up on his pole run at Richmond with a sixth starting spot. Jeff Purvis, Buckshot Jones, Shane Hall, and how about Dave Blaney? He rounds out the top 10. Good qualifying efforts here for the NASCAR Busch Series. In just about 13 minutes, those cars will be center stage. But pole qualifying next for the Winston Cup teams. I wonder what they're doing. It's Joe Nemechek's car. Mark Martin snooping around. In all actuality, Joe Nemechek, who finished 10th and 4th a year ago at the races. There's Jeff Bodine trying to figure out exactly how those long lenses work. What do people do when they kill time waiting for the start of Bud Pohl qualifying? Well, in the case of Jeff Bodine, you take up a hobby. And in the case of Jimmy Fennig, you talk to one of our pit reporters.
Thanks, Eli. You know, I told you at the top of the show that Mark Martin had the fastest time. He ran a 23.008. That's almost one-tenth of a second under the track record. What did you do to that thing?
I don't think we did none. We just unloaded pretty fast, so Mark's doing it all.
Jimmy, is there anything specifically, though, that you try to tackle here at Dover in prepping a car for qualifying?
Not really. Just basically, you know, it's about the same as every other place. You know, we just go by Mark's feel. Just keep concentrating on one-lap runs, and that's about it. You know, don't even think about racing. Just one-lap runs, and just go from there.
Well, I tell you what, they've gone from there very well. The chemistry between Jimmy Fennig and Mark Martin has been incredible, and Mark Martin absolutely has a great feel for this racetrack. He's my pick for the pole today. I'm going out on the limb.
A big old limb right there. And there you see Mark Martin. He is set to go racing. That to his left is Jerry Kinnan, who crew chiefs for Brett Bodine on the Paychex racing team. And that says what NASCAR is all about right there. Camaraderie from one team to the next. Sure, there's a lot of competition out there, but everybody gets along with everyone. Heck, you have to. You travel with them and see these guys more, it seems, than you see your own family. Let's check out the final numbers for the NASCAR Busch Series. There, Bud Pohl qualifying wrapping up a moment or so ago. And there you can pick out your favorite, Jeff Purvis, back last week in Richmond after serving that four-race suspension. Ricky Craven down around 28th place. They changed an engine today. The primary engine that they unloaded with went kind of sour on them this morning, so they decided to change power plants. And all the way down the line, you see Casey Atwood there in 32nd spot. Casey now driving as part of a business arrangement between Bruco Motorsports and the Hensley Racing Team. He takes over replacing Tracy Leslie in that Lysol car. And there you see everybody who's down on the list, right through to Bobby Hillen, whose problems we showed you moments ago. Mark Martin, 14 top tens here and 24 starts, Glenn Jarrett. That was a big old limb you went out on, wasn't it?
Hey, now look, yes it was, but look, Nemechek has come over here to find out, what were you doing snooping around in my race car?
Trying to find speed secrets, man.
Well, it looks to me like he should be snooping around yours.
I hope he's rumbling it off on this thing. He's quite a bit faster than I am right now. So
I think he's faster than anybody right now. I tried to get the answer out of Fennig. He wouldn't tell me anything. What's the deal? How come you're so fast?
Well, that was then. Now it's now. You know, this is now, and I don't know what we're going to do qualifying. Usually, Gordon, no matter what we do, he can go just a little bit faster. So we'll have to wait and see. But the cars just work well, and we came off the truck and got our best right away, and we'll see if, you know, we'll see how we are. The sun's out a little bit, things always change, different set of tires, so.
Well, Joe, you think maybe he is scruffing some speed off on your car? You were pretty quick, too.
Yeah, not bad. I mean, the second practice, we couldn't find the tire chassis combination that we wanted, so we're going on some scuff tires. They have a couple runs on them, and we'll see what happened. The car felt comfortable on them, more than the other sets, so we'll see. He's going on good ones. We're going on used ones. We'll see what happens.
Hey, that's going to be interesting to see. Thanks, guys. Good luck to both of you. Here's Steve.
All right, Glenn, thanks very much. With Jeff Burton. Now, Jeff, before we talk about Dover, I know you're focused on this race, but let's talk about Saturday night. What a great battle with Jeff Gordon. Had us all on the edge of our seats.
It was a great race. No matter who you were pulling for or whatever, I mean, if you're a race fan, that was what you pay to see. And, you know, it was a great race from the beginning of the race to the end of the race for third place, for first place. It was a whole night of good racing.
And you have actually had a pretty good, you know, streak going. You've been sick, had a concussion, but still, you've got to be encouraged by the way that 99 team has performed.
We're real happy with the way we've run. You know, early in the year, we faltered a few times and did some things that got us back in the points, but we fought our way back, you know, hadn't given up, just kept working, and real proud of my team for not panicking through adversity.
Let's talk about Dover. How do you feel about the setup here?
Well, we've struggled all day, to be quite honest. As we know, success last week doesn't guarantee anything for the upcoming week. And we've not been anywhere near as good as we need to be. We worked as hard as we know how to work, and we just haven't hit it. So we've had a problem qualifying here in the past, and I think we'll have a problem today. Key is just getting that thing to run good tomorrow.
All right, thank you, Jeff.
Jeff Burton, by winning at Richmond, moved from 7th to 5th in NASCAR Winston Cup points. So he was the big winner last week, and not only on the racetrack, but in the season-long standings as well. Now, the veterans, where do they figure in among all the youngsters? Dale Earnhardt and Darrell Waltrip, and our pit road veteran.
Well, that's what I want to see. I'm going to intrude a little bit on this conversation. And now, if this isn't two cagey old veterans talking, what are you guys talking about?
Talking about we need to go faster. I'm trying to figure out how to go faster.
I said, what's wrong with me is we're running the same speed here we were at Richmond last week. Somebody forgot to tell these people where we are.
Well, what about your cars? I know we've had a good bit of practice this morning, but it was all cool and overcast. It's heated up just a little bit now. Is that going to make a difference?
Nah, it's perfect. My car is perfect.
I like it hot and slick. That's the way I learned to race. Hot and slick, buddy. That's when the real men come out.
Well, the real men are out here today. We're going to let them continue that plotting. I know that they're trying something against these younger guys. They're lobbying for taller spoilers, less engine, and a slick racetrack. That's what Darrell wants.
I bet he does. Of course, the guy on the left there, Dale Earnhardt, starting his 600th career NASCAR Winston Cup race here this weekend. His first start was back in 1975, and he finished 22nd that day in the World 600. That was one position ahead of the man who now owns his car, Richard Childress. When we come back, the cars will be rolling. Bud Pohl qualifying from Dover is next here on Speed Vision. Welcome back, everybody. We are live on Speed Vision at the Monster Mile, Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware, where this weekend the NASCAR Winston Cup teams get set to run the MBNA Gold 400. If you were following the racing activity a weekend ago in Richmond, Virginia, you know that Robert Presley broke his right scapula. That's his shoulder blade to you and me. He was in that four-car accident there on the 33rd lap. Well, there's the car. It's here, but regretfully, Robert Presley is not. Steve Burns, who's behind the wheel?
And his relief driver is none other than Hutt Strickland. Hutt, what's the situation in the 77 car?
Well, right now, we're just taking this week, one week at a time, I guess you'd say. Robert called me last Monday, and told me he had broken his shoulder, and, was going to have to spend some time doing some therapy and everything. So, I'm just glad I can come in here and help him, hopefully, and, it's going to be a good deal for me, too. So, I'm looking forward to a good run this Jasper Ford.
All right, thank you, Hutt. Back upstairs to Eli.
Hutt Strickland from Calera, Alabama, just looking for rides as he can find them. There's the guy who's going to be joining us in a short while, the driver of the Cheerios Ford. That is Johnny Benson of Grand Rapids, Michigan, who will be the first driver out to qualify here in just a few moments. Kyle Petty's machine, you just see the nose of it right behind him. Kyle's Hot Wheels Pontiac drawing the number two qualifying spot. And then Chad Little will go third with the John Deere colors ahead of Mark Martin and Joe Nemechek. Those will be the first five drivers out to qualify, and we'll get a pretty good idea as to who's doing what in the number department. The track record is 155.898 miles an hour here at Dover Downs International Speedway. Rusty Wallace turned that lap back here on the 29th of May. Again, a look at the track description. Our Shell track description shows the 1 mile Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. That layout, 24 degrees of banking in the turns. The straightaways are 9 degrees of banking. And the straights are each 1,076 feet long. So it's a handful, really. There's no chance to relax at this racetrack. You've got to be on your best behavior, and oftentimes that just doesn't happen here at the Monster Mile. Here now is Johnny Benson, the first driver out to qualify, as Bud Pohl qualifying is underway. The top 25 spots will be filled here today, with second round qualifying set here tomorrow. There you see the banking on that back straightaway. That ride off the low side of the track through turn four, then right out to the wall exiting the corner. And there you have your 1 mile around Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. 153.846 miles an hour. That translates to 23 seconds and change, 23.400, well under that track record set here in May by Rusty Wallace. One guy who'd like to get things turned around here today is that gentleman, Ricky Rudd from Chesapeake, Virginia.
And Eli, this is a racetrack that he may well be able to do that. He has been to Victory Lane here several times. Ricky, we were just talking, maybe this is the weekend you get things turned around.
Well, it would be nice, Glenn. It's been running pretty good in practice, and we at the earlier practice we were the quickest, but if we can do it for 400 miles here, it'd be great. It's been a really good racetrack for me in the past. No guarantees. You got to come here and earn that win again, but probably one of my better tracks.
You earn your paycheck at this place too, don't you?
Well, it's tough. You know, they worked on the racetrack. It's not as bouncy as it used to be, and it's not going to be as physical as it normally is here. I think they worked on the track for the IndyCars when they came here and took a few bumps out. I kind of liked it when it was the other way.
Okay, best of luck to you, Ricky.
There you see Kyle Petty just wrapping up with the quick lap of the day thus far. Kyle's not had a top five finish since this race a year ago when he finished third. Of course, he's also won here at the Monster Mile. Kyle would love to duplicate that here this weekend. Chad Little now has the John Deere machine. It's a Ford Taurus back out onto the racetrack now. Chad Little next to qualify in car number 97. He was mid-pack earlier today in the practice runs. The speeds this morning significantly higher than they were in the practice that immediately led up to qualifying. And from Rodney Wise, the checkered flag, and the numbers will be third fastest of the three drivers to take time thus far. Kyle Petty quickest, Johnny Benson second, and then those numbers for Chad Little, placing him third. Now we'll get a pretty good idea, because the next gentleman scheduled to qualify, Mark Martin, was quick in second round practice. Not only does he have those eight top four finishes in the last nine races, he has 15 top tens in the last 16 races. So only once in the last 16 races has Mark Martin not finished the day in the top 10. Checkered flag for Mark Martin. Can he make an assault on the track record? Well, everybody checks the numbers. 155.9, that is a new track record. A new track record in qualifying. Mark Martin has just erased the numbers that Rusty Wallace set here back on the 29th of May and has posted a new track record, and obviously is currently on the Bud pole in the early stages of qualifying for the NASCAR Winston Cup MBNA Gold 400. Wally Dallenbach's team getting him set, while Kyle Petty is now second fastest. We are back at Dover Downs International Speedway. The man who is here for the very first time drives car number 9, Jerry Nadeau. He is now faster than Joe Nemechek, faster than Kyle Petty, faster than Johnny Benson and Chad Little. Jerry Nadeau, currently second quickest in his maiden voyage here at the Monster Mile, Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. Now pulling onto the racetrack, a gentleman who last won a race right here. Of course, it was way back in June of 1991. It's been a while since Kenny Schrader has last pulled off a victory. But he loves running here at Dover Downs. Let's see what he's able to do on the Monster Mile. That wall. That wall has grabbed him over the years. He had a hellacious wreck here years ago coming off turn four. Schrader's lap, maybe not quite what he was hoping for. He is sixth fastest of the seven drivers who have taken their speed runs thus far. As for Kyle Petty, he's now fourth on the day. There he is.
And Eli, he had a pretty good run. Kyle, are you pleased with that? Is it what you expected?
I tell you what, for the Hot Wheels Pontiac, like, that's not bad, because we run, that's the same thing I've run in practice. If you go back and look at the timesheets, I've run it, like, that's the third time today I've run that same speed. Either that's as fast as the car wants to go, or that's as fast as Kyle Petty wants to go. I don't know which way it is, but, you know, we were pretty pleased with it. Anytime you can duplicate what we do in practice, that's a good qualifying effort for me, because most time I lose about a second between practice and qualifying.
All right, thanks, Kyle.
Jeff Burton on the speedway right now in the Exide Ford. He has posted five straight top five finishes, including the victory at Richmond a weekend ago that jumped him up two spots in the point standings. And there his numbers are. He is sixth overall. So sixth quickest for Jeff Burton. Then there's Steve Grissom, of whom we spoke when we signed on the air. that team, the car looks great, Glenn, but they don't have any provisionals. They've got to get it on speed.
No, you're right, Eli. The Kodiak Ice brand being shown on the car now. Change it from green and white to blue. Good-looking car. What we want to know, we know that you have no provisionals left. You've got to get it on speed. Do you have it?
Well, the car seemed to be pretty decent in practice. You know, we just need to get picked up a little bit, and I think we'll be okay.
All right, I can tell that Steve is feeling a little bit of the pressure. He normally is a little more talkative than that, but he's got a heavy load on his shoulders right now, Eli.
No doubt he does, as Dale Earnhardt, in his 600th career NASCAR Winston Cup start, takes the checkered flag in qualifying, and where will he start from? Well, it's not going to be on the Bud pole. He is now slowest of the nine drivers who have taken their qualifying efforts. So Dale Earnhardt, some 3 miles an hour slower than the man who is currently on the provisional pole, Mark Martin, as we are still in the very early stages of Bud pole qualifying here at Dover Downs, Delaware. That's Darrell Waltrip now on the speedway. DW has the Tabasco colors set to qualify. Of course, qualifying has not been the strong suit of that car of late. Darrell Waltrip likes running here. As a matter of fact, if you remember back, DW was third here in the last race that they ran on the asphalt. Since it's been the concrete racing surface, though, it's not really agreed with him. And for Darrell Waltrip, currently eighth overall, a couple of miles an hour off the pole speed of Mark Martin, Darrell Waltrip, who has taken that past champions provisional for 7 consecutive races, qualifying 8 of the 10 who have already taken time. Jeff Gordon's ready to race. Brooke, his wife, alongside. We're back with more in a moment. That driver is now second fastest. Kevin LePage has just taken the Primestar Ford to the outside of the front row, joining Mark Martin on the front row, still in the early stages of Bud pole qualifying here at Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. That is Ricky Rudd, the tied Ford, set to go now. You heard from Ricky before. Has 4 wins here. 11 top 5 finishes, 4 Bud poles, and 40 starts here at Dover. That run right there makes him 4th quickest on the day. So Martin and LePage on the front row. Nadeau and Rudd currently in row 2. Joe Nemechek and Kyle Petty in row number 3. And Steve Burns, we talked to Jerry Nadeau earlier. Got to be tickled with that 3rd place qualifying effort thus far.
Well, Eli, we wondered how imposing this would be for Jerry Nadeau, and he goes out and rips off quite a lap. Tell us about it, Jerry.
My teeth are still chattering right now. But it's pretty neat. I mean, it's the first time here with these guys. First time here, period. I mean, in a Winston Cup car, Dover. So I'm pretty tickled with that. I mean, we had a good run in practice. We were good the first round. Second round, we're okay. But now we just we let it all out in qualifying. So I hope that's good enough for top 25. If it is, that's really good for these guys, and we can give them a good run for Sunday.
All right, Eli, he'll be scoreboard watching, but a good lap for Jerry Nadeau.
He's going to be solidly in the field by virtue of this first round of Bud pole qualifying. Kenny Irwin is on the racetrack. Moments ago, you did not see the finish of the Hut Strickland run. He qualified 14th overall. And Kenny Irwin now in the top 5. So the Texaco Haviland Taurus now in 5th position. The numbers you see at 154.832 miles an hour. John Andretti is going to be qualifying shortly. His crew chief is Robbie Loomis.
Yeah, and Eli, this has been one of the hottest teams on the circuit lately. They were 9th in practice today, but boy, have they run strong lately. Robbie, what have you guys been doing?
I tell you, John's has been doing a wonderful job for us. Here we're 9th in practice. You know, he wanted to make a couple changes. He's running plenty fast enough for us, but he wanted to run a little faster, and I told him I'd put him up against anybody come qualifying.
Okay, let's get a quick word from John. He's in the car now. I don't know how to tell you this, but Robbie just told me he changed everything under the car.
Robbie knows what's best, but I doubt if he did that. I think the SUV Pontiac's pretty good, but I don't think we can get Mark, but I'd just like to qualify.
Well, John knows we were kidding, but he did say that you were one of the best qualifiers. He's got faith in you. Good luck.
And for only the third time in his career, John Andretti now in the top 10 in NASCAR Winston Cup points. Rusty Wallace is now on the front row. He hasn't finished worse than eighth in 9 of the last 10 races, and Rusty will start, at least for the moment, from second spot. His qualifying effort still quicker than the old track record that he himself had, but not fast enough to grab the Bud pole from Mark Martin. Now Brett Bodine pulling out to qualify in the paychecks machine. Brett Bodine trying to find the right tracks here this year. It's been a tough season for him. As a matter of fact, he is the only driver to have competed in every single race this year to have yet posted a top finish. Matter of fact, when you take a look at the numbers, you'll see that top tens have been very, very sparse for Brett as he puts himself in 12th spot right now in the qualifying run. So Brett Bodine, qualifying in 12th, does not have a single top 10 finish this year. The only driver to have started all 25 races thus far without yet cracking the top 10. Here's Jeff Bodine now. Jeff no longer a part owner of his racing team. The Matei Motorsports team was purchased outright by Mr. Matei earlier this week. Jeff still had part of that team's ownership, but he sold earlier in the week. So now he is strictly a driver. A lot of talk as to where he'll be in 1998. Jeff Bodine, 7th overall here today. Currently in that 4th row with Joe Nemechek. Of course, Jeff Gordon is out to qualify soon with 12 consecutive top 5 finishes. Glenn, that's remarkable.
Oh, it absolutely is. And if there's anybody that might knock Mark Martin off that pole, that fast lap he ran, it would be this man right here. He loves qualifying. Can you do it?
I don't know. I didn't feel like we got our best lap in practice, so hope that we got a little bit left for him. But the sun's come out a little bit, and I think maybe the track's not quite as fast. Mark didn't run quite as fast. Nobody really has run quite as fast as what they did earlier in practice. So we'll give it our best shot. That's a pretty good lap Mark put up there.
Well, it was a good lap, but if anybody can do it, like I said, this man can, Eli.
I don't think anybody's going to argue against that at all as Jeff Gordon waits his turn. Meanwhile, Todd Bodine is aboard the Little Joe's Chevrolet this weekend, qualifying 16th of the 18 drivers who have taken time thus far. So just about almost halfway through, Bud Pohl qualifying. Rusty Wallace is currently second as you see the Chevron standings. Welcome back, everybody. Speed Vision bringing you live coverage of NASCAR Winston Cup. Bud Pohl qualifying from Dover. Jeff Green just wrapping things up in 8th place overall. Good qualifying effort for him. Just tuning in, Mark Martin is still fastest of the lot with a new track record of 155.966 miles an hour. He shares the front row right now with Rusty Wallace. There is Rusty looking on. Steve Burns, he came awfully close to wrestling the Bud Pohl away.
Yes, he did, Eli. 3 wins here to Pohl in May. Rusty, right now, outside of the front row, describe your lap.
It was a real good lap. It felt real consistent. I was a little off in turn 3, a little farther off than I wanted to be, but it was almost perfect. It felt really good. The same car I was on the pole with last time, but it felt almost identical.
Thank you, Rusty. Best of luck.
Dale Jarrett, who has posted 12 top 10 finishes in his last 15 races. He is 5th quickest overall. Meanwhile, the driver of the Cheerios Ford has joined us now after changing following his qualifying effort. Johnny Benson's up here in the booth. How you doing?
I'm doing great, Eli. How you doing today?
I'm well. Thanks for coming up and joining us. A pretty consistent lap for you. based on what the practice numbers look like?
Yeah, we need to go just a touch faster. We ran a 36 in practice and ran a 4.0, so I'm not sure where that's going to end up. But all in all, it was decent. You know, we feel the car's pretty good, so we're just going to have to wait and see.
And when Johnny talks about a 36 or a 4.0, he means the numbers after the decimal point, 23 seconds, .400 in this instance. Ran a 36 earlier in the day, so those are what the drivers refer to when you hear just certain numbers. It's a given here that you're going to run in the 23-second bracket, and in some instances, the high 22s some folks were talking about. That guy's had a great run. John Andretti, you saw him before. Say, well, we hope we get the job done. Fourth is not too bad.
No, he's got to be real happy with that. I mean, he's been running good the last couple of weeks, and it's glad to see them guys qualify up front.
You know, we talked earlier in the broadcast about those patches right there, the area that were used by laser beam technology to smooth out the racetrack. There you see one going towards turn number two as qualifying for Ernie Irvin takes place. Have those smooth areas really done the job? Did the laser do the trick?
Oh, it sure did. You know, it was interesting, you know, the first time on a track, and you see them spots, and we've seen them before, and we're like, oh, man, you know, you're not sure what's going to happen. And so far, they've done a tremendous job. You know, the track is great. It's in really good good condition, and so far, it's been excellent.
Well, that's a great report. Same thing the guys said from the Indy Racing League when they ran here. Same report from the NASCAR Busch North Series as well. Well, maybe not the lap Ernie Irvin was hoping for. He was real quick in practice today, now 13th.
Yeah, he sure was. I mean, I expected to see him right up there in the top five, maybe even a little bit better. And, man, he just barely beat us. And it's, you know, he's just been really strong, and I'm sure he'll be good by race day, though.
A bit later on in qualifying, we'll be seeing Jeremy Mayfield make his assault on the clocks. He's with Glenn Jarrett.
Jeremy, your teammate is on the outside pole. You were in the top 20 in practice, but have you got a little speed left? Can you get up that close to the front?
Man, I certainly hope so. You know, Rusty's really good here at qualifying, and the way our year's been going to qualifying, he beats me every week. So we're going to do our best to try to get it up front, but that was a good job for him in the front row there.
You know, I always love talking to this guy. He always sounds like he is the most excited he's ever been in his life. What a driver. What a great guy.
And he likes running here, though. If you remember, Glenn, he finished fourth here in May a year ago, and he missed winning by just 10 car lengths, so he's had some good runs. That, of course, is Sterling Marlin, and he will qualify in the 18th position overall. So Sterling Marlin gets himself in the field. One thing we do know about Sterling, we'll be talking about him late in the day, because he has not posted a DNF all year. He's finished every single race.
I tell you, that's incredible. I mean, their team has definitely got their stuff together. And just, you know, even if the car stays together, just staying out of some of the incidents on racetracks is pretty incredible to do that.
The last race he didn't finish was at Talladega last October. Well, that's the reaction for Jeff Gordon, who has scored 12 consecutive top five finishes.
Yeah, that's pretty incredible, isn't it? He's going to be a threat for the pole. I mean, you know, obviously, being a teammate of Mark, I'd like to see him there. But Jeff, man, he's been real strong all year, and their team's been really good. And, yeah, I tell you, they've just been running good and look good through 3 and 4 here, so I'm sure it'll be a pretty good time here.
What does the clock say? The clock says close but no cigar. Fourth overall. Fourth quickest for Jeff Gordon.
Yeah, still not too bad. You know, that's not a bad deal at all. I mean, anytime he's a threat for the pole, even if he's not, he's right there in the top five.
Remarkable, isn't it?
It is. It's their team has just got everything together and working real well this year. Actually, the last, you know, 3-4 years, they've been really good. So, you know, they're always a team to beat.
So Jeff Gordon qualifying in fourth place right now behind Mark Martin, Rusty Wallace, and Kevin LePage. And this is Jimmy Spencer in the Winston No Bull Ford Taurus.
He's been pretty quick in practice now. He's I guess he did some tire testing down here, and he's the one that says, man, the track's pretty fast, it's pretty smooth, and expects some fast times. And so far, he's been right on the money.
He also won the Busch North Series race that they ran here on the same weekend the IRL was in town, but he about lost it there off of 4.
I tell you what, he did a good job there, because I know if I was in that thing and felt that, that's a lot. It didn't look real bad, but I'm telling you right here, that hurt his time, though. I mean, that hurt him definitely, and you know, when you just slip a little bit here, you're not worried about, okay, I'm going to burn the tires up. You're just worried about making it, you know, to the line, and I'm sure he suffered a little bit with that.
Well, he'll be solidly in the field, an 18th overall. That has just bumped Hunt Strickland from the top 25. Remember, only 25 spots are up for grabs here today. So 25th right now is Dale Earnhardt, and Hunt Strickland has been bumped, and this is Gary Bradbury. Bradbury from Chelsea, Alabama.
When we were talking, you know, earlier about, you know, being bumped or not, it doesn't take anything here this weekend. I mean, just the times are so close. There's liable to be 10, 15 cars just within, a mile an hour or so, and that's what makes it so tough to qualify nowadays.
Dennis Adcock now working with this racing team, and again, Bradbury in about the same place Jimmy Spencer skated. Looks like it might be getting a little touchy off of turn four.
Well, I think, you know, a lot of people that go out and do the practice runs, the track's got just a little bit of heat in it because there's more cars there. And, you know, you get pretty good grip. Now, in our case, we had the same deal. We ran a fairly good time. We're happy with that. And it just, you know, when you go out there, the car slips and slides a little. Some guys choose to loosen their cars up a little bit. In the case that maybe Jimmy and Hunt did, and it's just, or Bradbury did, it's just, one of those guesses that you got to make when things are so tight.
Now, Bradbury did bump Dale Earnhardt from the top 25. He got in 22nd as Jeremy Mayfield now begins his lap.
Yeah, Jeremy, I tell you, he's had an incredible year, too. And it's the help that I'm sure that Rusty and the guys and their team, they got a great team there. Paul Andrews and Jeremy are really communicating well. And I tell you what, they're going to be a team that's going to be right there all the time. You know, and even though they have been now, but I mean, even more so in the future.
Well, they're going to communicate to one another that they have just qualified down in 17th position. So Jeremy in the field, but he's got a little traffic with which to have to deal with come Sunday afternoon. But we're still not totally finished with Bud Pohl qualifying. Mark Martin's quickest, yes, but there are some pretty quick teams yet to go. Kenny Wallace, one of them. Qualifying for the MBNA Gold 400 is being brought to you from Dover Downs, Delaware, by The Money Store, where America goes for money. By Big A Auto Parts. For quality parts, expert advice, and fast service, visit the pros at Big A Auto Parts. And by Texaco. Texaco, a world of energy. Eli Gold with Johnny Benson, Glenn Jarrett, and Steve Burns. As we continue, Bud Pohl qualifying from the Monster Mile. Mark Martin currently quickest. That is Ted Musgrave on the track. Dick Trickle, who ran moments ago, no surprise. We said on the opening of the telecast he was quick, and Trickle qualified seventh.
He did. I mean, that's great. I mean, he's been able to back up his time he ran in practice, and I tell you, that's an incredible time for them guys.
They have a new crew chief this week on an interim basis, Mike Hillman, replacing Tom Baldwin Jr., who's moved on to Ward Burton's team, replacing Chris Hussey. This, meanwhile, is Ted Musgrave.
Yeah, Ted, you know, he's been trying a lot of different cars here the last couple of weeks, and, it's a great run for him being there in 14th, 154.037 mile an hour, and that's going to put him good in the field. And Ted always runs pretty good here, so it's glad to see him get that car in the race there good.
Those who have been bumped out of the top 25 now include Hunt Strickland, Dale Earnhardt, Morgan Shepherd didn't make it in, Steve Grissom, Todd Bodine, and Chad Little. Why don't we take a look at the Purolator qualifying reset so you'll know exactly where the numbers fall right now.
I don't think anybody's going to mark off the pole right now. We thought maybe Jeff Gordon would do it. I'm not sure who's all yet to go. Bobby the Bonnie's been tough.
Bobby's been tough here.
He is pretty late. So I'm sure Mark's going to be sitting there waiting till the end here to see if he's going to be on the pole or not.
This is Wally Dallenbach Jr. driving the Budweiser machine. Became the full-time driver, replacing Ricky Craven back around the Michigan race in August.
Well, I don't think you'd be too happy with that.
Wally's down in 31st spot. As a matter of fact, that is next to last of the 32 drivers who have taken time thus far. How about Bobby Hamilton, Glenn? Does the Kodak team have a Kodak moment available?
That's a good question, Eli. We'll find it. We don't know if you got a Kodak moment ready for us. Mark Martin turned in an awfully fast lap. You were 27th in practice, Bobby. I imagine you just wanting to get in a good, solid run, get in the field.
That's exactly right. I'm never really good at qualifying good at this place, but we always race real well. Our car's always good in the corners. So we're actually a little better shape at 27th than what we thought was going to be when we come here. But the times have switched around. A lot of guys that were fast in practice aren't that fast right now. So if we can get in the top 25, we'd be tickled to death.
All right, Bobby Hamilton looking for a 180-degree reversal.
He said to me this morning, as only Bobby Hamilton can, as we watch Mike Skinner's lap, Bobby said this morning, he come out of Dover either smelling like a rose or smelling like stinkweed.
Yes, I've been in both positions. There's no doubt about it. Mike Skinner ran a good lap. It looks like he's going to be in the field today. And I tell you, them guys have been strong the last couple of weeks.
Skinner 14th overall. You may have heard the news earlier this week. His crew chief, Larry McReynolds, staying on for yet another season. There had been talk that he might move on, might start his own team. He says all of that has been put off at least another year. As we take a look at Rich Pickles driving for Cale Yarborough's team, he's also subbing for Robert Presley on the NASCAR Busch Series race here tomorrow, with Robert getting banged up over the weekend in Richmond.
Yeah, that's, anytime you get banged up in a race, especially the week or two before Dover, is awfully tough to come back and run this race. And, you know, you see him slipped up there a little bit in one and two, and I'm sure it's going to hurt his time, and that makes it tough. It doesn't take much to get bumped back here a little bit.
And as a matter of fact, he'll be 33rd of the 34 drivers who have qualified for tomorrow's, or at least Sunday's, race. Gary Bradbury bumped out of the top 25 moments ago, and Darrell Waltrip is now on the hot seat.
Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be more guys that are going to be on the seat here pretty shortly. And, it's just so tough to get around here. And every one of these guys are running pretty fast. Mm-hmm. It's just that the lap has just about got to be perfect to get in the top 25 today.
Here's Michael Waltrip, who has run well here in NASCAR Busch Series competition. Meanwhile, another young driver has been thrust into the headlines here today, and that is Matt Kenseth, who fills in for Bill Elliott, whose dad passed away late last night. Let's hear from Matt.
And Eli, so far, Matt has been doing an outstanding job. He was sixth quickest in the last practice. I tell you what, for short notice, you've done a great job so far, Matt.
Well, so far, so good. These McDonald's guys really got this car working really good for me, and it's driving awesome so far, so if I can just hit one good lap here, this is probably the toughest lap I've ever had to run. So if I can just hit it right here and hopefully get this thing qualified in today, and we can work on the race setup and have some fun there Sunday.
Well, I tell you what, he may be a little nervous. He sounds as cool as a cucumber, Eli.
Yeah, you wouldn't tell by knowing or by talking to him, but you're probably right. He's got to have pterodactyls running around in his gut.
Well, I tell you, Matt's a good kid, and he's a great race car driver, and he showed this year in the Busch Series he's got a lot of patience and knows when to get aggressive, and I think that he'll be fine when it comes time to qualifying here today.
Michael Waltrip's numbers before put him 24th overall, so he bumps his brother out of the top 25. DW, Darrell Waltrip, now bumped. And this is Terry Labonte.
I think Terry is pretty quick in practice. I didn't see exactly where he is at. And like I say, you know, the Hendrick cars are usually pretty quick, and we're just going to wait and see what he gets here.
Terry Labonte making his qualifying effort stand up with the exact same time as one Johnny Benson. So, Johnny, you and Terry are tied right now.
How does that work?
19th spot.
Do I get highest, that first? Seeing I did that first?
No. It used to be in the old days. Whoever went first, but now it's he who is higher in the points.
Okay, so do we both get bumped when this happens, or just one of us?
Well, fine.
I'm not sure. It does definitely go by the points. With Ted Musgrave, me and Ted, I forget where it was, ran the exact same time, and we were both right next to each other in points, too, so we kind of laughed about that a little bit.
So Labonte in 19th. Actually, he and Johnny Benson tying for 18th spot. Dave Marcus is on the racetrack as we check in downstairs.
And Dick Trickle is talking to the crew. Great lap for Dick. You're safely in the top 10 for the time being. Describe your lap.
Well, we've been right up to first and second in practice with the Heilig Meyer Ford here. And, what happened is you've got to late pick what you want. But, about six cars before me, the clouds went over, and we got complete sunshot for about six, seven, eight cars. And I got complete saturation of the sun. and it pulled a couple tenths out of my lap. It was a great lap. The car handled well. Mike Hillman and the guys did a super job. We've been fast in practice. That was a good lap in qualifying, but I'll guarantee you, two tenths was lost from the sun, and two tenths would put us on the pole.
All right, and as you said, Eli, Mike Hillman is his new crew chief. Tommy Baldwin left the team this week, so new crew chief for Dick Tricker.
Of course, that team owned by Junie Donlevy, who picked up a win with Jody Ridley here at the Monster Mile, remarkably 17 years ago. It doesn't seem that it could be that long ago. Here's Bobby Hamilton. Heard from him a short while ago.
Yeah, you know, he sounded pretty excited about getting a good lap in, and you know, they've been running decent this year. They've been up and down, and it's just, you know, just see what he gets.
Here he comes. He'll try and bump Michael Waltrip out of the top 25 as Sterling Marlin was bumped moments ago. But no, Bobby Hamilton himself only 31st quickest.
Yeah, he's not going to be happy with that one at all. I mean, it's still a good time, but yeah. There again, everything is just so tight.
So, Bud Pohl qualifying continues. Rick Mass says, I can't believe these numbers. Same with Bobby Labonte. Can anybody beat Mark Martin? Good crowd here at the Monster Mile. Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. Mark Martin still fastest of the lot. Eli Gold with Johnny Benson. Well, not a good qualifying effort for Kenny Wallace, but no. Buckshot Jones has had a good run.
I tell you what, Buckshot did a great job. He was, you know, been fast in practice, turned around and run a 23.271, which is 11th place. He's got to be real happy with that.
Now, Ward Burton is on the racetrack right now in the MBNA number 22. The gold color on that machine for the MBNA gold race weekend. Remember, it was the MBNA platinum weekend here back in May, and the car was painted accordingly that weekend. Let's see what Ward is able to do here today. He'll be solidly in the field, 13th best.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I mean, I don't think he was quite that good in practice. And, you know, I've been watching him because they're really fast here the first race this year and not quite as good this week. But I tell you, 13th, he's going to be happy with that. That'll get him in and they can work on a race setup.
Brett Bodine is bumped from the top 25. Meanwhile, Bobby Labonte, who made his first career Winston Cup start here back in 1991, there he is. Glenn, does he think he has anything for Mark Martin?
Well, let's find out, Eli. Bobby was third quickest in practice. Normally, a late draw is good, but now the sun has come out.
Yeah, it's the luck of the draw, you know. At least it's not a... It's too bad it wasn't a night race. This has been good last weekend for qualifying, but we'll just give it our best shot. But, you know, it's not going to be quite as good now as it was earlier, but I don't know that we could have beat Mark anyway.
Well, that's a pretty honest assessment there. He's just looking for a good, hopefully a top 10 start.
There you see the Matt Kenseth-driven McDonald's Ford. Again, if you're just tuning in, with Kenseth qualifying 13th in place of Bill Elliott. Bill's dad, George Elliott, passing away last night at the age of 74, losing his battle with cancer. And certainly our hearts are open and share the loss that the Elliott family is feeling right now. But Matt Kenseth fills in and admirably does well.
He does. I mean, like he talked, you know, he didn't sound too nervous. I'm sure he was. I mean, that puts him in a pretty peculiar spot. But it was a good qualifying laps, good and solid. He's in the field. I'm sure he'll be real happy with that.
This now is Steve Park. Steve Park has had a very eventful week.
Yeah, he went down and tested down to Homestead there and had a little problem and wrecked one of their cars. And I'm sure he's being real sore right now. There's no doubt. And like I say, Dover is not the place you want to be this weekend. Oh, and he gets a little sideways there. And you know, he doesn't need to hit anything else this weekend. I'm sure he's pretty sore.
But he's still all right. He's 11th.
Great race.
Yeah.
Great lap.
He's 11th right there. And that will bump Ken Schrader from the top 25. But a good effort by Park, who was banged up earlier in the week, was hospitalized for a CAT scan down in Florida, but was given the okay by the doctors to get back to all full activity. So he is here and right now is in 11th spot. Nobody's able to chase down Mark Martin nor Rusty Wallace. They've got the front row right now as the Remington Arms machine, the Ford Taurus for Rick Mast, is on the speedway.
I got a little looser in one and two, and you got real loose there coming off turn two. So I'm sure this is definitely going to affect our time, and it's You know, we talk about this sun all the time, and it's out right now, and it's not so bad on the concrete, but it sure has shown here real shortly. And I tell you, Rick's doing everything he can to get everything out of that car right there, and it's just a tough situation for him, and it definitely was not good.
No, he will be the slowest of the 42 teams to take time thus far. So not the lap that Rick Mastin wanted, as you saw. He was kind of fighting that race car all the way around the Monster Mile. So Jeremy Mayfield still on the hot seat as we are winding down towards the final few. Watch this again. Here's what Johnny was talking about.
Yeah, he was in trouble a little ways back there. I mean, this could have been a lot worse. He was sliding, and he hit it square. If he had hit it with either the front or the back of the car, he probably would have been in a lot more trouble there, and Rick did a really good job of saving that. And same with Steve Park.
Yeah.
Man, that's pretty incredible for not getting around and being as sore as he is.
Mm-hmm.
Did a good job saving that.
Well, let's see what Bobby Labonte is able to do right here.
I'm sure Bobby's going to run an okay lap, even though he's not sure. I mean, I'm sure he'll be comfortably up in the top five. And, you know, they just got a really strong qualifying effort, and I'm sure he'll be fine on this lap here.
For Bobby Labonte, it is close to the pole, but not quite. He'll be on the outside of row number two. So for all the questions and bad-mouthing, he is solidly in. He'll bump Jeremy Mayfield from the top 25. And guess what, Johnny Benson?
Hey, I think I might make it.
I think you're going to make it, my friend.
I was almost going to have to talk to Terry. I says, man, why'd you have to match that deal? But it looks like we're safe. And I'm telling you what, Cheerios guys have been doing a tremendous mm-hmm. job there at Roush Racing. And I tell you, every one of those guys could be real happy we're in first round so we can work on a race setup.
As Derek Culp is out, the final qualifier. And if memory serves, you won your first Busch Series race here, didn't you, at Dover?
I sure did, but man, it was asphalt.
That's true.
Yeah. Yeah, but the concrete's been decent to us, and I've been, you know, real excited about that. We had some great runs when I ran with Bahari Racing here, and you know, but I'm excited to be with these guys. You know, Ben Leslie's kind of the new crew chief here, and he's been working with us, and I tell you, he's doing a tremendous job for being pretty young at this spot, but it's been working out really good.
Well, let's see what Cope can do. Hey, Derek Cope will be third overall. Great effort for Derek Culp and the Gumout Pontiac. He qualifies third fastest. It bumps Jeff Burton from the top 25. And Johnny Benson, that was the final qualifier. You are in on the first day.
I'll quit run down there if there's more to go. I'm happy. Man, Doug Hewitt and the guys are a tremendous job there, qualifying up there in the front. And when I've run here, they've always had a great race car, so I'm sure they're looking good for the weekend.
A super effort right there, but I think we all kind of had an idea nobody was going to touch Mark Martin's lap.
No, I thought if anybody, Bobby, has had that shot, but, the sun was out a little bit, and that does hurt. I mean, you get sick of hearing about it, but it does hurt just a little bit. You can see that it's not a whole lot of difference between what Mark and actually all the way down to sixth place is within a tenth. So it makes it interesting sometimes qualifying.
A new track record, Steve Burns.
New track record, Mark Martin. Obviously happy with your lap. Was it what you hoped it would be?
We ran a little bit faster in practice than that, but that was probably because I didn't know any better. And after I ran that, I didn't think, I thought, you know, somebody might be able to beat it. Heck, I'm sitting there watching them. How about Derek Cope? Wow, what a run he put in. But, you know, we never turned a screw on it, thanks to Jimmy Finning and Sean Parker. Just they had it just perfect, and the car was fast the whole time. It always was comfortable. And, you know, I didn't care if we sit on the pole or not. The car felt good, and we got a good lap, and that's all you can ask for. And just happy for Valvoline, Cummins, Eagle One, and all the folks that support us. Pole, we already had a pole, and poles aren't that big a deal to us, but that gives us the number one pit stall, and hopefully if we do things right, we lead a lap there on the first lap and get 5 points, and we get a lot of our business taken care of right away in the day, and that'll give us the best pit stall, you know, on the whole pit road as far as pitting goes. So we'll have every advantage that we could have going into this thing, and we'd like to win another race.
All right, best of luck. That's his fourth career pole here at Dover, Eli.
And just think that in the decade of the 90s, that man, Mark Martin, is second only to the number three team in Dale Earnhardt for the most points earned in the decade of the 90s. We break away with a quick look at the Chevron Field summary. We'll have the full rundown for you coming up. More from Dover. Don't go away. Welcome back, everybody. Speed Vision with live coverage of Bud Pohl qualifying for the MBNA Gold 400. Eli Gold with Steve Burns, Glenn Jarrett. Johnny Benson is up here in the booth with us as Mark Martin has won the pole. The NASCAR Busch Series cars now going out for their final practice. They've got a 200-mile race here tomorrow. There you see some of those competitors, Elliott Sadler, along with Randy LaJoy, Tim Fedewood, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and the rest all set to go racing. Meanwhile, Glenn Jarrett has caught up with a fellow who'll start 13th here on Sunday. Maybe it's lucky 13 for Steve Park.
Actually, Eli, he told me he just got starting position 12B. It's not 13, it's starting position 12B. No, great run there. You got a little sideways, and we were talking, you didn't need another crash this week.
No, that's for sure. We had a wreck on Monday that's taken a toll on me, and this morning I've been a little stomach sick and just really haven't been feeling that good, and the bounce here at Dover's really taken a toll on me. So we're toughing it out for now, and the Pennzoil guys have done a great job. They put a good car underneath me, and we've been struggling the last few weeks, so it was nice to be able to come down here and get a good run in.
Well, congratulations on a good run, Steve. We'll let you go get some rest now.
Right,
as he said, he's not feeling well. I'll tell you what, they can rest easy tonight.
No doubt about it. They are in the field in starting position. All right, 12B. Meanwhile, let's take a look back at the qualifying run of Mark Martin. This is the U.S. Army Premium Performer of the Day. Can't argue with this, man. He was glued to the racetrack.
He was. You know, Mark gets around this place so incredibly good. And, you know, he's right down there at the bottom. You never see him slip the car at all. Even a lap that doesn't feel good, the car just sticks to the track, and it was about perfect. And he probably came in and says, man, I don't know if that was any good or not. And it turns out to be a great run.
He has a win here at the Monster Mile, a NASCAR Winston Cup competition. And he'll be starting on the Bud Pohl come Sunday. Now the crew will remove that qualifying engine and get themselves set for tomorrow's practice. And that is such a pleasant plus, as you too can experience, Johnny. You're in the field. You can get set for Sunday now. You don't have to worry about second round qualifying.
No, it was close.
Yeah, well.
Being 25th is a great feeling for us right at the moment. There's no doubt. And we can work on the race setup. And we need to do that. It is so competitive nowadays. You need that little extra to get the car right.
We're going to come back and wrap it up. A complete look at the rundown of qualifying while Mark Martin celebrates the win of the Bud Pohl. Don't you go away. We're back in a moment. Speed Vision's live coverage of Bud Pohl qualifying for the MBNA Gold 400 has been brought to you from Dover, Delaware by the U.S. Army. Be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. By GEICO Direct, the sensible alternative. By First Plus Financial. At First Plus, you don't need equity. You just need a phone. And by Purolator. Pure oil now. Pure oil later. Purolator. The NASCAR Busch Series machines on the Speedway right now. Final practice, happy hour for them. Elton Sawyer and Tim Fedewa and all the rest getting set for their 200-mile race here tomorrow.
Yeah, that's always, you know, a pretty good race. You know, I've been fortunate enough to win this race a couple years back, and they always put on a great race. You know, unless every once in a while, though, you just get one car that seems to really run good here, and it kind of makes the show not as good, but it's a good race.
Kevin Grubb is on the pole, but I think the big story, one of them, has got to be Dick Trickle, ninth in the Winston Cup race starting spot. And there you see the Schneider machine right there will be starting in the fifth position tomorrow.
Yeah, that's a great run for him. You know, them guys have been running so good lately, and it's great to see Dick run good in the Busch Series. You know, he's got two wins there now, and it's always a great victory when he wins a race.
Why don't we check out the Mobile One qualifying results. You'll see how everybody did in today's runs. Again, the top 25 positions solidly locked in. You know, track position is important everywhere. More so at Dover than other places, or not, Johnny?
Well, nowadays it seems to doesn't matter where you're at. I mean, track position is extremely important, and it's one of those deals where you can get up front if you got a good race car. Obviously, you qualify good, and then you can kind of, I mean, not relax, but you can just stay with the front guys there, and it seems like you can stay there most of the day, provided you don't have any minor incidents.
There you see the top 15 thus far. Matt Kenseth, that is correct. If you're just tuning in, he's in the Bill Elliott car this week. Bill not here, what with the passing away of his dad, George, just last night. And the next five will bring you up to speed on everybody who is locked in. Those 25 are locked in. And notice Johnny Benson and Terry Labonte with the exact same qualifying speed.
Come on, guys. Must have paid somebody off to put me up there 24th. I think me and Terry are supposed to be turned around.
Since you're here and Terry's not, we just be nice to you.
I don't mind the inside road off.
Now you see the drivers who one would assume will stand on their qualifying effort tomorrow because things are so very, very close in Bud Pohl qualifying, but you do have a chance to re-qualify tomorrow if you choose.
Well, there's going to be a couple of guys that'll probably stand and work on that race setup. You know, race setup, even though you might get bumped back a couple of spots, they're going to work on their race setup. It seems to be so important nowadays.
Taking you back.